In this video, you'll learn the steps to perform supervised classification in remote sensing. We'll use ArcGIS Pro to collect training samples and classify Landsat imagery using these samples. Okay, let's get started. So here I am in ArcGIS Pro. I have my Landsat imagery already in my map. Now what I want to do is first select my image in my table of contents. Next, I want to select the imagery tab. Now I'm going to click on the Classification Wizard button. This will open a panel on the right side of ArcGIS Pro. So the first input it's asking for is the classification method. So in this example, we're going to use supervised classification. So let's go ahead and pick that. The next option is the classification type. There are only two options. The first option is pixel-based, which is good for coarser imagery. Object-based is better for finer scale imagery. We're using 30-meter resolution Landsat imagery, so I'll pick pixel-based. So for classification schema, I'm going to pick the default option, which is the National Land Cover dataset of 2011. I'll just copy and paste my output location here. Lastly, if I have existing training samples, then this is my chance to add them in. Let's click the Next button. So the next step is the Training Sample Manager. The purpose of collecting training samples is to build a set of representative samples for each land cover class. You should accurately digitize areas that are labeled with their corresponding classes, such as vegetation, water, and urban areas. So I'm going to go ahead and use these as my classes. But it's possible to also create your own classes by clicking the plus button. So what you're going to do is you're going to choose a class. Next, you're going to select how you want to create that shape. And then finally, you're actually going to create the training sample. Let me show you. So I'll pick the water class for my first sample. Next, I'm going to draw a polygon. Finally, I'll just create a polygon in my Landsat imagery. Okay, that looks pretty good. Next, I'll select this developed class. Then, I'll go ahead and draw a polygon on my map. Alright, now I'm going to go off screen and come back in a while with more training samples. So keep in mind that you should try to get a representative amount of samples for each class. Okay, see you back in the next step. Once you've finished collecting all your training samples, you can move on to the next step. So let's click the Next button. There are a couple of options here for which classifier you should pick. I'm going to suggest using either random trees or support vector machine. Personally, I get the best results from these two classifiers. So I'm going to try our random trees and see how things look. Let's push the Run button. One of the really nice things about the Image Classification Wizard is that it's trial and error. So if you don't like the classifier you chose, you can just go back and change it to a different one. Alright, so it looks like the tool ran. But I'm curious to see how it compares to other types of classifiers. So let's try out Support Vector Machine. I'll go ahead and choose that classifier and keep the default settings. Let's push the Run button, but using this new type of classifier. Alright, so it looks like the tool ran. Now, we have both the random trees and support vector machine classification in our map. You see what I can do here. I can turn my layers on and off to see how they both performed. As you can see, both land cover classifiers do a fairly good job to represent land features. But they're definitely different from each other. So you really have several options if you run it multiple times to pick the one that is the most accurate. If you have a validation dataset, this would be a good time to check the user and producer accuracy. Alright, so that's about all that I have for this video. Supervised classification provides a systematic approach to classifying pixels based on a training dataset. From creating training samples to choosing a classifier, I've explored the key steps involved in supervised classification in ArcGIS Pro. Remember, Mastering supervised classification requires practice, so continue exploring, experimenting, and expanding your knowledge to unleash the full potential of supervised classification. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope it has provided you with a solid foundation in using supervised classification in ArcGIS Pro. I'll see you next time.